Hello there, amazing people. I need to move my water bottle here. I'm going to talk a little bit about something that seems to confuse people when I talk to them. It's a little bit about my opinion about Linux. So I'm going to talk about Linux, what I feel about it, what I think about it, and all of that fucking shit. I don't know, it would be mostly just me talking, and then of course there'd be something on the screen, so you don't have to, you know, pay attention to. I'm not showing and telling on the screen, I'm more talking, but it's just if I need to show something, it's ready on the I can, you know, use good old Google. If you're a Linux fanboy, this is not a video for you. I will plain out say and burst the bubble and say, if you're a Linux fanboy, you will not like what I'm going to say, because as much as I like Linux, there's a lot of things that makes me come up with the opinions about Linux that I have. And a little bit of context to my opinions about Linux. I have to kind of put my credentials out there. I've been using Linux, what, we are 2022 now. So I think I installed the first Linux distribution around 2006-07-ish. Let's just say 2008 was the first time I really used Linux, okay? So I've been using Linux non-stop for 25 years, or 24 years. When I mean non-stop, I mean I have always had Linux running in either on a laptop or a dual booting, or ran Linux full time in that period. So from 1998 to 2000, dual booting, messing around, trying different operating systems and stuff like that. From 2000 to 2008, when I got my Macintosh back then, when I wanted to try Macintosh, I ran 99% of the time Linux, different Linux distributions. Mainly, for 6 months, I ran BOS for a little while as my main operating system. But for the most part, I have been running Linux. And then once in a while, for work or something like that, I would have Windows either on my laptop, or I had to do dual boot into Windows to play a game or do something for work or educational purposes and stuff like that. But 99 to 95% of the time from 2000 to 2008 was Linux. And I tried almost all of them. Ubuntu, Arch, Mandrake, Mandriva, SUSE, OpenSUSE, or whatever they were called back then, Stackbear, Gentoo. I tried them all. I ran them all. And from 2008, like I said, to 2010, I ran macOS and dual booted with Windows on the boot cam on an iMac, and I had laptops with Linux on them, not Windows, Linux on them. From 2010 to around 2015, really into PC gaming again in 2010, so I moved over to Windows. And then I either dual booted with Linux, or I ran Linux in a virtual machine, or I had Linux on a laptop. And from 2015-ish, 2016 up till now, it has primarily been Windows with Linux in a virtual machine. And in 2022, I got my first ever actually MacBook Pro. So, and that's just running macOS. So I'm not dual booting it or anything like that. That's my current situation. So a little bit about my history with Linux up till now. The plain truth about Linux.
That is huge! That is absolutely huge!
That I hold in right now at this time, I could change it. I have changed it many times over the years, but it has kind of stayed the same for the last 3 or 4 years, and it's not a good opinion. And we are talking Linux on the desktop, not on the in the corporate world or on a server market, because Linux for a server, I'm all for it. Linux in the corporate world, if it can be done and if it makes sense, I'm all for it. I am all for it. Linux on the desktop, on the other hand, The longer I have used Linux on the desktop, the longer I kind of don't like Linux on the desktop. I like it as a development machine. I like it as a testing machine. But running it 24/7, the older I got, and the less time I have to actually maintain my computer, you know, sitting and they actually have an update here, so might as well just do it. Sitting here and being a system administrator for my computer, fix things that goes wrong, you know, edit stuff and, oh my God, there's an update to this program. Now it's not working. I have to go into edit file and stuff. You know, all these things that we deal with under Linux, sometimes more, depending on the distribution, sometimes more often than not, and sometimes barely at all. I stopped having time for that the older I got. And this is a normal situation for a lot of people. When they get to their 30s, they start to, you know, families, kids, and all of that fucking shit. They start to value other things in life than just sitting and nerd out on a computer. And it kind of also happened for me, not the kids and family stuff, but valuing my time other than just sitting in front of a computer. I want to be more social and stuff like that, even though I'm an antisocial as a motherfucker. But I want to try and be more social, so I don't have the time to fiddle and mess around and tinker with Linux. And I don't need to do that with Windows as often, or even at all, or with macOS. I may do some Python or Bash scripting to keep my mind fresh and learn a little bit about that. I may research some subjects about Linux, because Linux is great if you want to research technology, because you can see the source code. And because you can see the source code, it's also easier it's easier for other people that know how to read the source code to make white papers and analyze the source code. So you can learn from it. That's what I mean, that Linux is great for learning and stuff like that. But for everyday use, yes, I can run Linux every day for the most of the things that I'm doing, and I could probably also game under Linux and be happy. It's just that, why would I be happy with not having the same performances as under Windows? Why would I be happy with not things not working the correct way as under Windows? Why would I be happy with not being able to program my mouse that needs a really, really good cleaning, by the way, under Linux, but I can do that under Windows? If I want to change the colors of my mouse, the fact that I have to boot up a virtual machine with Windows to change stuff like that on my peripherals makes no sense to me. It's fucking irritating, and we can debate why they are not supporting Linux and they should support Linux and all that. That's another debate. The fact is, it's not here. Another thing that really has, in all the years I've been using Linux, and this is just the first statistic I could find about Linux here, and they do say that it's really hard to get statistics about Linux and operating systems in general, and this is web client OS's family statistics, so that means that it's a JavaScript that reads what operating system you have, and not all websites are running it, so you don't get the whole picture, but you kind of get an idea about what the picture is. People or operating systems that are accessing websites is Android as number one, and no, Android is not Linux. Windows, we all know what Windows is, iOS and macOS, then we have unknown. It could be Windows, it could be Linux, it could be whatever you want. And others, it could be Windows, Linux, whatever you want. It could be FreeBSD, others could be FreeBSD, unknown could be FreeBSD. Then we have good old Linux here at 0.93%. And that's my whole deal about this Linux thing. Depending on what statistics you look at, because again, statistics is not 100% accurate, but depending on what the statistics you look at, the Linux desktop market share has almost stayed the same since 1999. Let's say 2000 to today. Let's say, on average, the average market share for Linux is 2%. Sometimes we hit 3%, sometimes we go lower than 1%, as we have here. I think the time we had the most market share was around Windows Vista days, where we were actually, I think we were creeping up with 3 or 4% of the desktop market. But it didn't last. If we look at that statistic, like I said, let's just say that in 22 years, Linux has averaged 2% of the desktop market. If Linux could not capitalize on Windows Vista and other planters on Windows and macOS, where they had problems and plain old massive faults, you know, there are plenty of videos about why Windows sucks. If Linux had not been capitalize on that people wanted to go away from Windows or macOS and keep the users that tried Linux. And this has been going on for 22 years. The future is not looking good. You can do whatever you want on Linux. Linux has a lot of great things that's going forward, but it's still just Linux. It still don't have mass appeal. It still don't have what people want. The market share has basically stood still again on the desktop front since 2000 or 2004. that's another reason why I'm not that hyped about Linux anymore. And here's another thing about Linux that also don't make me think favorable about Linux. Linux has not changed the computing world. What have Apple done? The original Macintosh, you know, iMacs in the late 90s, you know, the first iMac was fucking amazing. You know, this beautiful thing here. This beautiful thing here that everyone wanted in the 90s, you know. iOS, iPhones, you know, tablets. The whole touchscreen. The reason why we have touchscreens today or is as popular today is because of Apple. Windows, you know, almost... Well, Windows is the reason why we are using this paradigm here. With a menu, a bar and a menu button that you click on that have a hierarchy or a list of applications sorted in another list. This is because of Windows 95. Windows 95 changed the way people used computers. The original Macintosh did it in the early 80s. Windows 95 did it up till now and continues doing. This is the paradigm that 99% of people are used to using and like to use. The Windows paradigm. That's a massive fucking, like, thing. Like, Windows 95 will be remembered forever for that. The iPhone, the iMac, you know, Mac OS and the original Mac OS, you know, Mac and the original Macintosh, stuff like that, will be remembered forever. When Linux dies out, it will die out at some point. It will just be a footnote in the history of the computing world. Another thing is that if you talk to tech people and if you talk to people that are into technology, a lot of them know about Linux nowadays. They did not do that in the early 2000s, but nowadays a lot of tech people know about Linux. And they have probably also tried it. But why are they not sticking with it? Because Linux is not providing what the user wants and has not been doing that forever. And have it not been doing that forever, it will not do it in the future because of all of the distributions I've seen and all of the fucking projects I've seen in Linux in my 24 plus years with Linux, don't give me any inclination that's going to change. Yes, we are getting Pantheon, we're getting more flashy and user-friendly programs and stuff like that, but we have to remember, they are not Adobe Photoshop. They are not this, they are not that, and alternatives is not the same. Why I'm not so hopeful about Linux, us, Linux nerds. We are doing a shit ton of damage to ourselves. No other tech community have more infighting than Linux users. Systemd versus i6 or other init systems. GNOME versus KDE, Flatpaks versus Snap Packages, Dev versus RPM, Rolling Release versus Static Release, Arch versus Ubuntu, Arch versus the World, Gentoo versus the World. Should I keep going here? And on top of that, we are fighting against Windows and Windows users, and we are yelling and screaming and bitching and moaning, and we are fighting against Mac users and bitching and moaning about them, and software licenses. Being in the Linux ecosystem is one big argument. One big argument. And that's not fun. It's draining as fuck. It's like shooting ourselves in the foot. We are the smallest guy in the operating system world. We are bitching and moaning about everything. It's not a fucking good thing to be. We should be accepting to everyone. We should be non-combative towards anyone. Linux have to live in a world where macOS is the thing and Windows is the thing. We need to be cooperating in a world that's a thing. The same with software licenses. Linux need to be able to live in a world where there's other licenses than the GPL or the BSD license or the MIT license or whatever GPL compatible licenses out there. And until Linux can do that, Linux will go nowhere. Like, here's something we have to think about. I have seen Windows and Mac users recommend Linux to people and people in the IT industry. I have rarely seen Linux people recommend Mac OS or Windows. I don't dislike Linux, but I don't like Linux. I don't dislike the Linux community, and I don't like the Linux community. I'm neutral. I'm not that hyped about Linux on the desktop. I don't really care that much about Linux in the corporate world. I'm not a system administrator, developer, or anything like that. Linux for me is just something I do because it's interesting for me. Linux is just something I do to keep my brain active. Linux is a great system to learn coding on, programming on, and tinker with. And that don't mean you can't do it on Mac OS or Windows. You can, and you can learn just as much about your computer and software development and software engineering on Windows and Mac OS as you can do under Linux. It all depends on the person. Anyway, I'm out of here. Long one. See you all later. Bye-bye.